This is a very quick video on how to name rays and angles, and some of the common mistakes that people make. This is a ray, it has an end point right there, and there's another point that's on the ray, and we're going to name it with the end point first. The order does matter. So this could be called ray EF, but you can't call it anything else. You could use the ray symbol, and it always goes to the right. You have to do it that way. You're not going to ever point it to the left, and again, the end point's going to be first. Well, here's another example of a mistake that people might make. Often they'll give you a ray that will go to the left, and they'll name it something like A, B, and C. They'll put those three points in there, but you don't name it A, B, C. Again, it starts with the C and then any other point on the ray. Again, those arrows will go to the right. Now let's name some angles. Well, sometimes they'll just give you number 1. That's not going to be the number of degrees, it's just naming the angle, angle 1. See that little angle symbol. They may also name it with the vertex, that's the endpoints of the two rays, so they could be angle Y. Now, sometimes they're going to name it with three letters, and notice that the Y, that vertex, has to be in the middle if you're going to use the three letters. Now, what if that is the vertex of another angle? We have WYZ there. It could also be ZYW, but that's the only way you're going to be able to name that unless they give you another little number like that number 2 right there, angle number 2. But notice that Y is now the vertex of two different angles, actually three. You cannot use angle Y to describe those angles anymore. That is a very common mistake. So again, three letters is the most common way of naming an angle. Again, the vertex must be in the middle, that Y. And sometimes they will give you a number, but remember those numbers, like the 1 and 2, are not going to measure the degrees.